Meanwhile, somewhere on the motorway, on the way to the Drabble Show. Oh my God, I think it's going to move. It's moving, it's moving, it's moving, it's moving, it's moving, it's moving, it's moving.
I forgot to press your button now, didn't you? It's because I'm so small, I can't reach the keyboard. Because it's me, Potato Kale, broadcasting this week's Abracadabra live to all of you wonderful listeners out there. Hello everybody and welcome to Abracadabra, the show where we invite commanders from the elite dangerous universe to take part in a little competition by submitting a drabble to our little competition. What's a drabble, are he? You say?
What's a drabble?
Well, thank you very much for asking, because, you know, a drabble is a short story of exactly 100 words. And for the purposes of this competition, it's set in the Elite Dangerous Universe and to a theme picked by the previous week's winner. Now, we're just hot off the road from Fairleigh. In fact, we've only just got bloody home because our traffic was absolutely chuffing nasty. It really was. It just wanted to sit still. I mean, an acid spill. Surely there's plenty of stoners near Manchester that are willing to lick that shit up for free. No need to close all the lanes. Just go. Acid Paddy on the M6, come on, everybody getting... Oh, my arm fell off. Oh, shit. Oi, big guy, can you take over, because my arm's just falling off and I can't do any shit, man.
Oh, okay, do you want me to take over, are you sure?
My arm fell off. I can't reach the buttons, my arm fell off. This is really bad. I'll just push it back. No, it won't go back in that hole. Don't push it in that hole. That one hurts. Ow. No, just you take over.
Okay, no worries. Thanks, Potato Cow. We're here. Welcome, everybody. And good evening. And, oh, creaky powder hat and everything. It's over here. Oh, it's good to be back. It's good to be home. And finally, in this big nightmarish week that LaveCon week was, it's so much fun. And of course, we are joined by a number of people who are actually there at LaveCon with us in the TeamSpeak chat. Good evening, everybody.
Pickford.
Oh, Chuff.
Hello.
Simon's
hello.
Arrived.
He soiled his undergarments and he flies.
Yes,
now, the question is, do we hear it or do we see it?
Oh, alien, no, that's him just arriving. I can't foretell that.
The chance that you will get a vote is
getting rare.
So kill that pig, or it's symptoms you will share. Your duty bound to do is fight this, aka Pig Park.
So we are here in this wonderful world of drabbles, and thank you to everybody who took part in the LaveCon drabble. What the hell, Potato Cow? Don't push buttons with your... Oh, right, your arm fell off. Yeah, that's nasty.
We've got a new drabbler tonight.
Ah, well, we'll save the fanfare for them. So we are here back again for a week. Is that Simon now coming in? I mean, we did get a big clue that you were coming because, you know, we got your announcement.
Could smell them.
Apart from that too. Hey. So we're joined. Let's just go quickly. We'll go quickly through the TeamSpeak channel. We're joined by somebody with no name but icons. So I don't know who that is. Let's just have a look and see if it's a description. It's Galactic Midden. We have Antarius Fusion, who was at LaveCon. We have Odemon Crew, who was not at LaveCon. We have Aylesgriff, who was at LaveCon. We have Alien, who was at LaveCon. Icini, who was at LaveCon. And Moof, who wished he wasn't at LaveCon when it turned out I'd forgotten half the kit. Ah!
Icini's new catchphrase is, come and see the show.
Shade, let's see the alien get shaved.
Oh, that's what I remember. I just got to say a big thank you.
I just got to say a big thank you as well.
Oh, it's bloody Moof.
Looping back as always.
Turn it off. Here's tonight's cat sick. I'm gonna mute him. Get control of your banana, mate. So this is a lovely little glass that was presented to me by Mr. Hankey, and it says for the mug, waypoint scoop on it underneath the Lord Psycho Cow. And tonight I am drinking cat vomit. Oh, with added mango. It's delicious. Bit sharp. So, we'll have a quick look and see who's joining us in the Twitch TV chat. We've got quite a few people. It's quite a wee full wee room tonight. We've got Frank. He's alive. Fantastic. Academic Dust Ale. Arexac. Commander Moon Prayer. Felix Bast. Icini is in there as well. Lunarctic. Moose666, Playpay, Decorkin, and Whatcha. Good evening to you all. Welcome to this.
I am not dead yet. I can dance and I can sing. I am not dead yet. I can do the Highland thing. I am not dead yet.
I shouldn't have thought that, you know, 2 weeks away from this would have encouraged people to just take it a bit easier on the old soundboard, but no, not at all. Ahoy, shipmates! Right. So I suppose we should really try and get on with things then, eh? Try and see if we can run this show to schedule. Oh, crikey. Can anyone actually read the Twitch chat? That's quite small fonty.
It's a bit tiddly.
It's a bit tiddly, ain't it?
I was
messing around with monitor resolutions today, so things are a little bit out of whack, but we're getting there. Right. So, at this point...
Out of what?
Pickford. Out of whack.
Pickford, he sails across the ocean, a ship he can't fit in. He soiled his undergarments and he flies from out his bin.
Are you still driving?
Evaluation for the scurvy in his skin. Hideous face, a shard of force, other diseases are there, of course. Pickford. He's bad. The drabble crowd of drabbers is groaning, so beware. The chance that you will get a vote is getting rare.
I was bringing the screen while I was going
on.
Pickford weekly,
all the symptoms you will share. Duty bound to do be smart, it's kill sign.
And the screen of dreams is down. Is I think we'll have a wee karaoke version of that later on. Mr. Moof, are you driving in traffic, or is that the sound of fans?
I don't know what that sound is. Something's going with all my audio.
Yeah, I had a bit of a setup day today. Well, maybe we'll just do a quick nod to LaveCon. We'll go through what happened at LaveCon because it was an amazing weekend. And if you were there, it was great. I know Simuf and I were stuck behind the curtain of doom, lying under desks of shame and plugging things into holes where they go and hoping beyond hope that picture would appear in the right places and in the right order. And then start the broadcast show and then run out again to fix the audio because they hadn't told us needed audio. That kind of craziness. We were wrapped around those green screens like... I don't know what wraps itself around green screens.
but the thing is, I did find that it was very calming.
What was very calming?
My.
No. I mean, you're gonna have to go and kick your audio demons. It's cutting you about.
Ah, bollocks!
Funnily enough,
chirping.
Funnily enough, what the hell? That came through really loud and clear, as always. Well, we just remind everybody that this stream is indeed suitable for adults and not terribly suitable for children or people of a particularly easily offended nature. We try and keep it clean, it just sometimes strains. I have not looked at this week's Drabble selection at all. I know what the theme is. I didn't get a Drabble in myself this week. It's a shame. I'll try and get back into it next week. And I've not read them, which is something I like to do because sometimes it's quite fun to catch out on a Friday night and it adds to the enjoyment of nobody whatsoever Yeah, Lunarectic, you're going to need an adult. Definitely somebody who will hold your hand. If you are underage and you shouldn't be watching this, then just remember to put your browser into private mode and all should be good. Right. What the hell, hey? What are you adding to the bot now? Has it not got enough? Has it not got enough mad, monstrous, mental piles of crap that fly out?
That bot's out of order. It's going to drag us down.
It is. Right. I'm using the course of, for fuck's sake. Right, the bot. We're going to come up with the last week's winner, of course. And as you can see there, last week was a quiet week in the run-up to LaveCon. And we can see that Drabble number 6 was by... Fucking hell. Saimuth won last week, so much is explained. I vaguely remember that we were still driving when that poll finished. That's just not right. Yeah.
But no one voted.
Yeah, 7 voters, 9 Drabbles.
Oh, God. Can we...
How did you
feel? Again.
How
did we get out of this bus?
I mean, that sounded quite tuneful there. Do you want to give us a little run of what you've managed?
Yeah, but I mean, going on that it was bad in the car, my flute playing. I think we should let the audience decide what my flute playing's like. So I've come up with this wee bit, and I've gone for a kind of Hindi flavour for it. just in a minute. Sorry, somebody came in there.
That also sounded like a string instrument.
No.
Okay, so yes, for the entirety of the drive down to LaveCon, Simon decided to teach himself the flute. I'm surprised
because he's a bastard.
I'm surprised he's been able to remove the flute from where we shoved it and then hammered in. But apparently he has, which is unfortunate.
Yeah, some idiot gave him a second flute.
No, something we need to confirm, because I don't think we've got any photographs of it yet, but Mr. Wonderful Eric Marquet is travelling the UK. Now, his brother won the Drabble competition at LaveCon. Sean, congratulations. It wasn't quite a Drabble. He was a couple of words short. He is working on getting those words to me, but we tend to make allowances at LaveCon because, you know, people are drunk. And we witnessed something special. Not necessarily me. We witnessed something pretty impressive, which was we saw and touched and held the Drabble crown. It's real.
Oh,
we've
yes.
seen it. It's
oh,
real.
Oh, we sure did.
So we'll need to get some pictures when they turn out.
It's real.
It's real.
It's real.
It's real. It's no longer the virtual Drabble crown.
It is real, yes.
It's an actual Drabble crown. So... what we need to do now is, of course, we've got the last week's winners and the poll was closed, and Saimuth, who so talentedly won the Drabbles. What did you pick for the topic this week then, Mr. Saimuth?
Well, we were driving at the time, and... I picked flute, I did. I thought there was something that just came to me, and I think I went for traffic.
Yes, indeed you did. And in honour of Saimuth winning,
fired.
We have prepared his national anthem, and we invite you all to rise to your feet and stand.
What's happening?
Ready yourselves to sing along to the national anthem of Saimuth in honour of his Drabble win. Here we go, everybody.
What's happening?
Pickford. He sails across the ocean in a ship he can't fit in. He soiled his undergarments and he flies from the spin. He leads a valuation for the scurviest skin. And his spin is short for the Pickford. He's mad. The gravel crown of rappers is growing so rare. The chance that you will get a load is getting rare. So kill the Pickford weekly or the symptoms you will share. Your duty bound to do be smart as kill Simon.
Again,
here we go, his national anthem. Thank you, please be seated as we carry on the Drabble Show post LaveCon.
Yeah, that, sit actually, down.
That's actually come out quite well.
Well done, Pickford. Yeah,
you will all regret this.
Thank you for the assistance.
Simon, you know those times in LaveCon when you're looking at me and going, I know you're up to something. That was it.
Oh.
Right.
Well, thank you.
We're going to move on. And actually, our first drabble is by Alien. Now, Alien, would you care to read your own drabble?
No, that's your job. Get on with it.
Oh, I'll read your own drabble.
No.
Give the ban a break.
Okay, well,
you vote for it.
I should rather. Drabble number one is by Alien, and it's titled Traffic Jam. And it goes a lot like this. Sweating. Move a few inches. Stop. Sweating. Move a few inches and stop. Sweating. Move a few inches. 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 Stop. Sweating. Move. A few inches, stop. Sweating. Move a few inches, stop. Sweating. Move a few inches, stop. Sweating. Move a few inches, stop. And that's when the heat killed Simuth.
Well.
That was
all back.
Yep, I thought that was written rubbish, read rubbish, and just rubbish.
Can I just say, I really couldn't be arsed writing a drabble this week.
It's quite cool.
We could tell.
Show at all.
It does bring the memories back. I actually feel hot and sweaty just listening to it.
Who cheered that one? Frank, what's wrong with you?
Yeah.
Check the old man for Alzheimer's, he's definitely lost it. Oh, Fletchmo!
Where does he keep his house? Is there two of them?
Right. I'm not sure. I'm glad you cut off during that little comment there, that was kind of fortunate.
Damn it!
Travel number two is by Bong! And they are called How They Bore the Crown from Lave to Hutton.
An epic lay of Conehead, the barbed hairy one. Ah, wait, I think I know a shortcut. Count for the next 73 parsecs. Reduce speed now, single lane traffic only. Next services, 18 light years. Reduce speed now. Single lane traffic only. Are we there yet? No overtaking for the next 43 light years. Major space works ahead. Detour. Debris fueled ahead. Dead slow. Let's stop and ask this guy for directions. Is this the second? About. Cones end. It's going. Mute Simuth, that's right. Cones End, 3 parsecs. Is this still the second roundabout? Welcome to Lave, from the land of the mug to the home of the cone.
Well, what do we reckon about that one, guys? Get your cheers in the chat. Aylesgriff, did you enjoy that one?
I did. I liked that one very much.
I give it a 5.
It didn't leave an awful fong in your mouth. That didn't sound right. A fong.
No.
A fong in the room.
I haven't had one of those since last weekend.
Is Moof still bouncing back? Let's have a listen and see.
No, my audio driver is gone fruity.
Fruity. Fruitini.
Tasty.
Yes.
Ooh, Mike Snoswell is going to burn there for you, Midden. They got you to talk to the crown, and that's how it was born. Drama number 3 is by Roots Rat, and is titled Homan Traffic. There were way too many security ships around here. I was drifting towards a station, cold and silent. Just before the mailbox, a warning flashed on my HUD.
Scan detected.
No! I had a cargo full of slaves. That's it. I'm going to spend the rest of my life in a prison. A message arrived.
Thanks for your cooperation, Commander. Welcome to our starport.
What? What? Impossible. Impossible.
Your shipment of organic meat will surely improve living standards on our station.
Meat? I checked the ship systems and stared in horror at the line that read, cargo hold life support. Off.
Now, this isn't creepy, Frank. This is the voice inside your head. The one that tells you to breathe in. Breathe out. And hold your breath, Frank. Hold it as long as you can. That's right, a bit longer now. Keep going, you can let go now, it's your time.
Right. What's going on, Midden? Uh-oh. Really?
It was better when you stayed out of it. Now you come back.
Now you come
and turn
back.
It all and to shit. Now Darkstone's black face has ruined Drabbles for you. And you and you and we tried to think of one thing that we missed about you.
But there's nothing that we gave a piss about you.
Darkstone's Drabbles are back to crucify you. And you and you and Darkstone's Drabbles are poo. Yes, Jim's a pervert, it's true.
It is true. Oh my god.
Which is also true. But irrelevant, really, but it fitted the song. As Moof manages to sort his audio, is he still bouncing back like Skip Rat's... never mind. We'll leave him just now. He can send me a wish. Good evening, Mind Wipe! Nope, can't hear him either. Okay, not yet. Moof seems to be a bit better now. Right, so let's get on with our... the next Drabble, which is Drabble number 4, which is a Drabble by Galactic Midden. Would you like to read your
Hooray!
Own? Would you like to read your own one, sir?
Yes, please.
When it comes to Middens, what? I think you should be asking people if they want to hear it.
Hey, does anyone else want to hear this Drabble?
No.
Can mute Moof.
Mute Midden. Mute Midden while you're at it.
Yeah.
That'll take a long time to read.
Let him go away and read it.
Okay, drama number four is by Galactic Midden, and he's going to perform it himself, and it's called
The Voyage. The Voyage.
Mute him. Shh, everyone. Shh.
The Voyage.
The phenomenon. Incredible. Every time he tried leaving, docking control reported a delay due to severe congestion. He turned to number two, a strapping young commander called Sporn, from an exotic land nearby. "Suppose you could do the boarding wait." He handed over control. "Clearance granted," docking control replied immediately. "Can we escort you? Free wash? Complimentary nuts?" the docker pleaded as he exited towards the starting point. And there it was, the beginning of the Hutton Highway, a chain of Type 9s, cutters, a diversity of ships, marking out points of respite all the way to Jack's station. That's the winner, right there.
Yeah, I hear the drabble, but what's it about? I don't get it. I just don't get it. I don't get it. What's it about? What's it about? What does it mean? What's it about?
In the title.
Yay! The Voyage. The Voyage.
But how potatoes can't drive?
Snozwell was attempting to lip read that drabble. I shall remember that for the next person that reads, and I will mouth all kinds of rude stuff and see if Snozwell can get my secret response. This is a secret message for Snozwell. Right, let's see if he gets back to us on that one. And oh dear me. Oh dear, I do hope he didn't decipher. But never mind. Drabble number five is by Moose666. And it's titled Traffic Gnomes. Because that's how you pronounce that. No, my wife, no one's hearing you at all, I'm afraid. Okay, so Traffic Gnomes by Drabble number five. By Moose666. And it's titled Traffic Gnomes. Pardon me.
Report.
It's alien travel.
No, Moose666.
Report.
The bridge of the cutter had just been plunged into darkness.
As a comms connection into the navigation computer, some seriously high traffic.
Suddenly, the lights flared back on, but all the displays had a disturbing sight.
It is I, the AI form of Pornounum.
Captain, the computer storage system is... Pornounum laughed in a disturbingly obscene fashion. Disturbingly obscene. Well, what is it? It's 20 exabytes of horse porn on it. Again, the laugh.
It's all intertwined within my fractal systems. You have no chance of getting me off.
He laughed again, the speakers on full volume.
Oh, That's porn. Nobody knows exactly how many exabytes or half gigabytes in an exabyte. He's got horse porn.
Well, that one gives my vote.
What's the next about?
What's that move?
Are we voting for people to kill?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, well.
Maybe in the next one. The next drabble is drabble number 6 by Simuf. Do you want to be killed for your own drabble?
It's your... What? No!
Kill him, please.
Drabble number 6 is by Simuf. And it is titled... Verily is it so titled. Titled as such... The Rubbish Driver. Thank you. Drama number 6 by Simon. The Rubbish Driver. Midden took in the view. Black,
hey, what?
Void. Bereft of life. Unchanging, monotonous. He'd grown sick of seeing it. Some people said it was beautiful. It wasn't. It was ugly. It was stomach-churning. It was also time to wake it for the shift change. Psycho Cow groggily took the controls as Midden prepared for his 6-month cryo sleep. Remember, ahead keep right, Midden shouted before slipping into his well-earned rest. A blink for Midden, he awoke to see the rear end of a ship. He prodded Psycho Cow awake. 5 months I've been stuck behind this. You do know it's a billboard. Yeah, all I can say is...
That was brilliant.
Nukit from orbit. Nukit, Nukit. What do you reckon in the chat? That's Midden giving it a cheer.
Oh, wait, the chat.
Yep, Simon's given it a cheer. That doesn't really count. No one else. We'll see how many votes he gets. Oh dear.
Our next. All my votes.
If only. Drabble number 7 is by Royal Hanky, the person that gave me this beautiful shot glass. Psycho Cow, for the mug, waypoint scoop full of catsic.
Yay.
Drabble number 7. Boy. Oh, we can hear you in a mind wipe. Drabble number 7 by Royal Hanky, and it's titled Lessons to be Learned. Oh. Traffic. What's traffic? A good pilot follows diversions. Bad pilot takes ages to get to the venue because he follows the flow of stationary traffic. An idiot pilot follows his brother's app directions. Keep right, keep right, keep right, ahead, keep right, ahead, keep right, M6, ahead, keep right. We're not on the M6, but it says M6, ahead, keep right. But we're not on the M6, we've not been on the M6 for 10-15 minutes. But it still says, shut up, Tom Bob. An idiot pilot follows his brother's app directions. Keep right, keep right. A good pilot knows the best route to take. But that's not what an idiot pilot does. An idiot pilot doesn't make waypoint or scoop points. A good pilot never listens to Psycho Cow's music. It is a fatal mistake. You run out of fuel. Ask Mad Dog, he knows too well. My only suggestion is to read the pilot's manual. Only idiots don't. Farewell, commanders. What do you reckon of that one, guys? Everyone in the chat.
It's funny because it's true.
It's true. I love it. Yeah. Bad because he used M6 instead of something else.
Definitely art imitating life.
It's almost good.
Actually, that's a fair good argument.
Fart imitating life.
I noticed that all this wasn't being said about my drabble at the start of the show, which was actually very accurate.
Hang on, did I miss your drabble, alien? Hey, thank God for small miracles.
Alien's drabble was ripped off, though.
Was it?
Yep.
Yep.
Oh, was it?
It was written completely in my own style of writing. Nobody else ever writes that way.
My eyes are burning.
Thanks for the follow, Blugger. Very aptly attempted. Giving it just a nice possibility. Right, halfway through an alien rant. Where are we? We're at drabble number 8, which is by Texas Stew. And drabble number 8 is traffic. No, it's not traffic. Drabble number 8 by Commander Kicks is oh, for fuck's sake. I'll start the show again. Drabble number 8 is by Commander Texas Stew and is titled Traffic Would Be Preferable. Let's go for a DP voice. 504 hours later, Commander Bucknaked woke at the strange clicking and whirring sound somewhere near. Unintelligible to Buck, it sent an icy chill throughout his entire body. Approximate translation follows. The first hive mind.
One last try this one.
The first hive mind. Deranged water bags expanded more. Grade 2 traffic to 80 DD-D 774-CE-2. 64.309% saturation of their cure. 12,540 lures found. 2 bait stations depleted. 213 strategic locations ready. 478 total implants currently in cloaked mode. 21 current key positioned implants cloaked. 1 prospective key implant located. Acquiring. While making his log entry, Buck could not help but think of his cow and say, "Follow Mark." Ooh. Ooh. I like that drabble.
I like the voice even better.
Do you like my scattery voice of doom?
Yeah, you're hired. We'll talk later.
Mind wipe show. Time to listen. Time to turn.
Definitely talk later.
Yay!
If I say fart, is it no? Oh, sign with apostrophes. Right, okay, so we have finished that one now. We have a special drabble coming up next. That's drabble by Cecil B. Trumpington. And I'm going to close the music down for this one because it is a unique one. And he has joined us live in this... Cecil, that was absolutely known for that.
Are you going to do the first drabble trumpet intro then?
You know what?
Well, it is Cecil's first drabble, so you need to do the first intro thing.
New Drabbler for this week! Welcome to the fold, Cecil! We have
a
Drabble by Cecil.
Fucker you are, mate. You're not parking that there.
Charming.
Well, peel me a hamster and fucking till the kettle boils.
But we are going to listen to this wonderful reading by Cecil B. Trumpington. So sit back and crank your speakers up to 9 and enjoy this beautiful piece of prose.
Some gin, bourbon, and
let's just try that one again. Apparently
the board off, bud.
Apparently, that key is the same as another key. So let's move it.
You're just doing that. You're a donkey.
I believe the technical phrase is Cal. Whoops.
We have no word for that. Otherwise, we'd never stop saying it. Oh, Cecil, would you like to read your drama now?
Cecil inspected his burial hall.
Okay, stop the clapping.
You can turn Cecil up a wee bit.
Says who?
Says everybody.
Okay. Alright. You're going to wish you hadn't
said
that.
Oh, says we all.
Here we go.
Take three.
You know, anyone would think this was a recording.
It's not. It's Cecil in the corner. Listen. Cecil, take it away. Come on. You can do it.
Cecil inspected his beverage hoard. Some gin, bourbon, and mugs on board. To Alvin DeFeer. I have a plan. It's Cecil B. here. For the mug. Launched his ship, iced, poured, and took a sip. Dear God, called Cecil. I can't see straight. Get out of my way. I mustn't be late. I seem to be having a bit of an issue. I've dropped my gin. Quick, grab some tissue. Get out of my way. This booze is illegal. I really shouldn't stay. I'll dodge all this traffic and get Lael back. Oh, bother. I'm wedged in the ruddy toast rack.
Thank you very much for that. That was a wonderful drabble from our first-time drabbler, Cecil B. Trumpington. Thank you very much. We really appreciated that. Thank you.
I don't think there's any reading any other drabbles. I think we have this week's winner.
What? What?
Yeah. What? That was bloody brilliant.
Join us again next week.
I withdraw my drabble.
And the only thing remaining is what happened to last week's drabble.
I withdraw my drabble and I withdraw aliens as well.
Yeah, I believe they ended up as a Docker script, if I remember rightly, because I remember after it was picking them all up.
Yes, that's very true. There was an awful lot of Docker scripts left in that table, and we'll get it up there. We'll get it on the Twitter web so that you guys can enjoy it. Drama number 10 is by Frank. Have we done a pulse check yet? Anyone? Anyone checked Frank for a pulse?
He's dead.
No, surely not.
I think Twitch channel is actually waiting for the back. There you go.
I am not dead yet. I can do the Highland thing. I am not dead yet. No need to go to bed. No need to call the doctor because I'm not yet dead.
No, he's not yet dead.
He's not yet dead.
Yeah.
Yeah. He is not yet dead.
Keep
him on the clock
because he's not dead. So, good news. Frank, do you want to read your own drabble?
Aye.
He's in intercourse. According to Wankbot, Cecil has been working like a trooper all day on his HCS.
You knew that was coming.
Loose. So, yes.
I miss that. I miss my weekly Frank fix.
Missed it that time there, Alien. Right, so drabble number 10 is by Frank, and it is titled I'm Not His Keeper. Joe's Starbike sped past the line of queuing spaceships, heading towards the docking slot at way over the speed limit. He glanced against the nacelle of an Imperial Clipper. All hell broke loose. The Imperials fired at Joe. The station fired at the Imperials. Everyone fired at Joe. Joe's father was watching dispassionately from a python that was stuck in the queue. Your brother's one hell of a pilot, the way he's handling that Starbike, weaving and dodging all those lasers. I'm amazed he clipped that spaceship in the first place. Frank shrugged his shoulders.
You think that was accidental?
Good drabble there, Frank. I like it.
That was good, yeah.
Can it compete with the mighty Cecil? Might you be in second place? Who knows? Find out on Sunday.
What's happening on Sunday?
The competition closes.
Elite Meet.
EGX.
There's a poll.
I hope so, yeah, we'll get to that though. Drab number 3 is not done yet. No, it's done. Ages ago. Drab number 11 is by Clean My Ass and it's titled It Won't Be Long Now. No, it won't be long now. And it's all about Midden's penis after he had it bitten off by a dog.
Oh. Ow.
Quick, quack, quack, quitch, quitch, quatch. Drama number 11 by Cleonimus. It won't be long now. Onion Head.
Ugh. Onion Head is famous. It's a common drug used in anarchy worlds by pirates of all political persuasions. The effect varies from pilot to pilot. Many become quite ticklish, others are prone to manic killing sprees. Jeff had purchased his first onion head 3 days ago and made his way to deserted, out-of-the-way system to try it. Alone, floating in his Cobra, the effects had been more unusual. Convinced his ship was trapped in a holding pattern, he was sure he could soon jump back to civilization. Just as soon as the star changed from red to green.
Actually, you know what? That drabble's not just good. It was
Van-Davy-Dorsey. That was good.
Aliens drabble was utter shite.
You said it.
Hallelujah.
Some little bits of there, alien. The rest of us are lager.
I said my own drabble was utter shite. What's wrong with that?
Yeah. Well, the rest of us are lager. Don't worry about it.
Drabble number 12 is by Felix Bast and it's called
Human Traffic. There is a traffic of human misery. A traffic that takes a human life.
You know what this needs? This definitely needs some deep, dark, miserable music.
Why don't you play the whole song?
Mind wipe. You're just killing the mood, man. Seriously.
Sorry.
Travel over 12 by Felix
Bast. Don't
talk
over Grant. Bad form.
I'm going to stab you in the face. With skip rat and sausage. Travel number 12 by Felix Bast. Human Traffic.
There's a traffic of human misery. A traffic that takes a human life and grinds it down until it is a raw, soulless corpse. A traffic that leaves a sane human being weeping in despair at humanity's inhumanity. A traffic that makes you wish for a restart button for the universe. I hate this kind of traffic, and I always seem to get stuck in it every time I come to Akinar to sell slaves. Still, it could be a lot worse. I could be one of the poor sods stuck in the cargo containers that fill my hold.
That was beautiful.
Mom!
And now for a quick word from our sponsors. Thank you for that sponsor. It's a strange sponsor, that one.
Where is the shouty man?
He'll be trying to recuperate from a really shitty travel. If our travel home was bad, his was horrific.
Yeah.
He did pop in to say hi.
So he has been out. So cracking drabble there, Felix Bass. Well done. Crikey, that's the last three drabbles have been, four drabbles have been spectacular. Drabble number 13 is by St. John Hawk, and it's titled Chaos at Lave Radio. Listen to Dadio, dangerous podcast. It's the elite.
Elite.
Drabble number 13 by St. John Hawk. Chaos at Lave Station. There was problems at Lave Station. A Type 9 broke down inside the entrance. It caused chaos, space horns sounding everywhere. Traffic control was in a dilemma. Police Vipers couldn't go and do their patrols either. It was bedlam. No one could help. The station weapons was not operational. This went on for hours. People had to go and do a lot of scooping. They would run out of fuel and otherwise. It was a long wait when suddenly power came on. Everyone jumped for joy because now it could be sorted. And that's when the station weapons killed Simoof's Type 9. Wow.
Wait a minute.
I don't believe Simon's ever been able to afford a Type 9, to be honest. But other than that...
Yippee.
Did Simon get into that T9? I don't know. It's a potted plant with a penis. Yes, Mr. Tree. It's a Mr. Tree. I'm still searching for a clue. It's a mystery. Vinti On is asking, was that the sheriff? I shot the sheriff or I shot the sheriff? Yes, very good, very good, very good pun. It's not quite a punch.
Yeah. Well, peel me a hamster and fuck it till the kettle boils.
Yeah, thanks, David. Drabble number 14 is our last drabble offering of the week. Oh.
No.
Oh, no. It's okay. We're... Oh, shit. 6 minutes to go. We have to wait. We'll have to make sure we crash it because I believe that Karash has a special guest on their show this week.
No, it's
Cecil.
Right,
don't
know what you're talking about. No idea.
Yeah, I just don't know who it could be. Someone special that really doesn't want to be late.
No, don't know what you're talking about.
Let's give this some thought. What could possibly be happening on Karashi's show? Who could possibly be waiting anxiously for us to finish so that they can jump across? Which splitter in our ranks is waiting to join the Karash landing?
Oh, that'd be Winard, because he's not here.
Is it Wankbot?
You're too modest.
Must be Simuth.
Is it Wankbot?
No, it's not Wankbot.
It's Mr.
You.
Potato Head.
Nope, it's not me. I've not been invited.
Mind Wipe came in late.
It'd be Bang Tae-yun. He's not in TeamSpeak either.
No, someone is it Alien?
Is it Potato Head?
We have a big, massive round of applause there for Simuth, who correctly identified the splitter in our midst is, in fact,
Thank you.
Thank you. Letter. I'd like to thank my family and my producer and everyone.
You've got a producer.
Really have us prepared for this.
No. We have a trophy for you. Here's your trophy. Live in the stream, perfectly, yeah. You know.
Is your toilet not flushing again by any chance?
Drama number 14 is by Insane Photon. That's a plaque. No, it's a plaque. It looks like a shit. No, that's a plaque. Drama number 14 by Insane Photon, titled Flying Ant Day. Which is quite bizarre, actually, because we had quite a lot of fun with the flying ants. We say that, you know. So we're going to do this one in the style of Eric Markey. Yeehaw! Yes, we are!
No, sirree! We're gonna read this like we the Markey ourselves. That's right, it's time for the American accent. And here we go with Drabble number 14. Insane Photons Flying Ant Day. Yeehaw! It's right! I grew! I did, it is, it's true. I grew up on an agro world. Every summer on a particularly sultry calm day, we'd get flying anty. It seemed like every ant colony erupted. Countless thousands of worker ants fussed around the winged queens and males that were about to seed off to establish a new colony. I guess that you could see what we're doing here in the shipyard is something similar. Yeehaw! We're a tushin' tardin' and tarnation. The system is buzzing with heavy traffic as we race to complete the stations. Much like the ants, we will send them out to an uncertain fate in hope of a brighter future. Yeehaw! Well, fuck my horse.
And that's that one over. Well done, Insane Photon. What a spectacular drabble you have there. And I've done Eric Markey proud.
That was a great Scottish accent you just did.
Yeah, a very quick return to horse porn at the end for you.
Yeah, just to slip it in there, which is a really bad choice of phrase.
With horse porn, it's never just...
That whoop sound is actually sounding more pleasant now, isn't it, Cal?
Yeah. Right, let's go and put away the screen of dreams for another week. There we go, up you go, here we go, here we go. Again, just a quick opportunity to say thank you to everybody that took part in the Drabble competition at LaveCon last week. We could always do with some more Drabbles. I'll need to rethink about it and maybe do something a bit more, I don't know, try and get some more Drabbles in, because... I think we had about 8 or 9 this year, which is good, better than last year. So maybe next year we'll get 20.
Ah, there's Winard.
Has he appeared?
He's still time traveling.
I do think powering your TARDIS by the power of wank is very short sighted.
Really? Have you seen Peter Capaldi?
That's an eyesight joke as well, thrown in there for free. Enjoy!
Hey. He's his companion. They'll never be all out of wank.
Shit. Right, so we have gone through tonight's offering. That only remains now for all of you people out there. Who is it keeps firing up these memes? Is it memes or memes? I don't know, who cares? The only thing is to call up the vote potato to remind everybody this week to please visit abracadrabble.com/vote to register your votes for your favourite 3 Drabbles from tonight's selection.
Not your own alien.
Excluding your own and aliens. And also... vote for your 3 favourite Drabbles from abracadrabble.com/vote and to join in on Monday afternoon when the new theme is picked by the Sunday night winner. abracadrabble.com/new will take you right, there you go, you can see now, take you right to the post where the topic is named, and it will give you a rundown of the rules, which are fairly straightforward. 100 words exactly, excluding title, theme, blah 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 blah.
I have an idea for a new theme.
Do you?
Red button, red button.
That annoying arsehole.
Funny, that was last week's topic.
Hey!
That was last week's topic. Alright, oh, so.
No, last week's topic was Eric.
And yeah, it's unfortunate for me to say that one, isn't it? In honour of Simon's achievements, we'll stand once again at the end of the show for the national anthem of Simon. I'll be upstanding.
Pickford, Pickford, Pickford.
He sails across the ocean, a ship he can't fit in. He soils his undergarments and he flies from out his bin. He needs a valuation for the scurvy and skin. A hideous face, a shark horse, a shot to pull us out of the deep. Pickford, 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 he's mad. The drabber could have drabber his corals, so beware. The chance that you get a hold of his get some tea rare. So kill the Pickford, we owe you some symptoms you will share. Your duty bound to thank you very much, and I think we'll have to pass the question over to Aylesgriff. Aylesgriff, is there any burning questions that you would like to ask?
Oh, I know. What happened to last week's troubles?
I have no idea.
That's the best that's ever been done.
It became the Docker script live. Told you.
Ail should read out all the troubles.
I agree.
Just, you know what, it's about recycling. You guys.
Better than usual,
you guys, and you guys, time. Another travel host, please be found for next week. Another travel host, please be found for next week. Thank you. Somewhere on the motorway, way to the travel show.
This mum's dad's cat belts ring cock flash shit pants hurdy poo lick nipper scratch bags for munching pus stuff pan burger.
Oh my god. Big old. I think it's gonna move. It's moving! It's moving! It's moving! It's moving!